The youth at my church, PFC, went on a retreat where I was assigned to group to be a chaperone of. While at the campsite, each group had to come up with something that was spiritually edifying and encouraging in any creative form. My group was named The F.I.R.M, Forever Investing Righteous Men, and together we came up with this powerful skit, But God. Ladies and gentlemen, The F.I.R.M.
Hi, my name is Brandon Brown, aka Michael Jordan II. I have 27 NBA rings. I'm the best NBA player that ever stepped on the court. I get girls without a problem. And, you know, why do I need God? I'm basically king.
Hello, my name is Clark. I'm a professor at Harvard University for astronomy and a dean at Yale. And me, along with several of my colleagues, believe strongly that the Earth was created in this Big Bang theory that two atoms created the whole entire universe. So how could some superior being have done any of this?
My name is Omaron. I am, well, most of y'all should know, I'm one of the world's best R&B singers from here to Japan. Better than Chris Brown or Usher will ever be. All my concerts are sold out and I get 3 encores a night. The garden begs me to play for them. People ask me all the time, oh, you should sing for the church. But church? What am I singing for the church for? I give my grandmother money every month for her to pay tithes. Isn't that enough for y'all? People say, oh, God gave me that voice. No, I bust my butt for this voice. God gave me that.
Hi, my name is Matthew Carter III, actually. I am one of the richest men in the world. I'm actually 3rd on Forbes list, and I own a Fortune 500 company. I mean, I have everything, from the cars, to the wife, to the kids, to the mansions. I have everything I could ever want. I don't need anything from anybody. As a matter of fact, I sign your checks. I mean, I'm the biggest person in the world right now, and nothing gets any better than me. So why do I need God or anything else? Give money to the church? Please. I am who I am. I made me. I am money and money is me. Come on, get real.
But then one day, as I'm about to enter my game, 28th ring, you know? Championship game, 10 seconds left. I'm running down the court, dribbling, cross Kobe, cross LeBron, shook Wade, turn around jumper. As I'm going for the perfect jumper, this fan comes and tackles me. I break my ankle. The doctor said I may never walk again. So I lost my contract, lost my billions, and girls don't like guys who can't walk. So I had to move him back with my mom. So as I was just chilling in her bed, a gust of wind came in and opened up a Bible. And I mean, I haven't read it in a minute, so I started to read. I think the scripture that I read was Isaiah 53:5. I think it said, "But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed." I mean, I have to believe in something. You know, the doctor, despite of what the doctor says, the Bible does say, by his stripes we are healed. And 3 months later, the word came to pass. With deep faith and prayer, the NBA signed me again. And I was back on track.
A couple weeks ago, I went to an astronomers convention in Maine. There, I stood at a hotel room. That night at the hotel room, something spoke to me. Some strange sound told me to open up the drawer in the hotel room. There I found a dusty Bible. The sound told me to flip to the page, Revelations. In that chapter, I read Revelations 1:8, I believe. It said, "I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. saith the Lord, which is, which was, and which is to come, the Almighty. And then I realized all my life, all my hard work, and that I was reading all these textbooks, I only got part of it correct. There was a big bang. It was God. He said, let there be. Bang!
Then something happened. I got in a car accident, and my throat was cut, and my vocal box was damaged. I couldn't speak or sing anymore. I lost my job, my fans. I started to lose my home. I couldn't find other jobs. So I started selling things in my home. All I had left was my couch and my bookshelf. One day I was loaning some payments, so I looked through my bookshelf to sell some books, and I came across the Bible. I opened it up, and a scripture fell out that my grandmother gave me. Bottom of the note, it said, if you ever need God, just call out to him. But I couldn't speak, so I was like, how could I do this? But I trusted, and I called out to him, and suddenly I can speak again. And later on, I was able to sing. Now I'm the choir director of a church, but only through God.
So one normal day, I wake up, get the kids dressed, make some breakfast, turn on the news, says the stock market's down. I mean, not like any normal down. I mean, it's hundreds down.
People went home and thought about the developments over the weekend and returned for the apocalypse on Monday, October 19th, when the U.S. stock market collapsed. The Dow Jones dropped by 508 points, a 22% decline, far surpassing the 12% decline of the 1929 crash. It was estimated that $500 billion in paper values had been lost.
So I flipped to Fox 5 News and it says, the stock market has crashed. I turned to CNN, the stock market has crashed. It's crashed and I'm paranoid. I don't know what to do. I mean, that's my money. I call the bank and they say, I have no more money. I'm freaking out. 2 days later, the repo man's talking about, hey, you gotta hand over your keys because we're taking your car away. And I'm like, how are you gonna take my car away? That's my way to get back and forth to work. But then I realized my business is gone too. And then the next day, the mortgage company's calling saying, hey, you're gonna have to get out. And then 2 weeks later, my wife is leaving and taking my only son. She's taking my son away from me because I don't have any more money. And I'm in this huge house, lonely, with no one to talk to, no one at all. What am I supposed to do? And then the next thing I know, I'm living on 42nd Street. On the street, I'm living on the street by myself. And this lady's coming up to me, she's preaching something about, hey, God loves you and, you know, he really cares about you. You should come stay at my church. So, you know, I took her at her word, and plus I was hungry. I needed something to eat. I've been on the streets for weeks. So I'm over her, and I'm eating, I'm chowing down, and the pastor calls me over. He goes, hey, come here, I have something to tell you. He goes, God told me to tell you that, for what profit shall a man gain if he loses the soul and gain the world? And, you know, it stirred something up in me that, you know, maybe, just maybe, I don't need the world. Maybe it's God that I'm seeking after. And 3 months later, I'm a deacon at this church, and I'm praying, and I'm asking God just to show me the path, and my wife calls me, and now I'm seeing my kid again. And now things are getting better. And the only thing I can say is, but God.
But God.
But God.
But God.
Forever.
Invested.
Righteous. We are the F.I.R.M.
See?